Dr. Sherazade is in as you never left. He's still in the house. He comes in with knowing dreams, the meditations.
Yeah, like Sam.
What hard do I smoke cannabis? Because we smoke it, he comes on the smoke.
Okay. So, our lecture today about how to read hieroglyphs. So, as I explained before, that the language is called ancient Egyptian language. And it is written in three scripts, or what we can call it handwriting. So the first handwriting, or the most clear for us, is the hieroglyphic style of writing. That hieroglyphic style of writing is what we said, it is the clear details and the complete details of the letter. Like this. Okay, when we look to the check, we can see all the details. Is there no doubt, any doubt that this is the check?
That's the check.
Okay, the rest of the pictures. So that is what we call it hieroglyphic. What about hieratic? Hieratic, they make it a little bit simple. Still have details, but they didn't care much about 100% details. Demotic, also less details. So we can say hieroglyphic 100% details, hieratic around 80% from 70 to 80% details, demotic maybe 30-40% of details. Because hieroglyphic was made by professional sculptors and carvers and writers in the tombs and the temples. Hieratic was mainly written in papyrus by the priests, so it was easier a little bit. And demotic was written by locals. And also papyrus, or sometimes small pieces of stones. So locals will write very fast, because a symbol like this, to write this in a tomb or a temple, at least will take from 5 to 10 minutes, maybe more a little bit, maybe less a little bit. But if I do this in demotic, it's going to take like 2 seconds or 1 second writing this. It's going to be always the external line. They make the beak and the shape of the head of the chick, because the owl has another shape, the vulture has another shape.
That's why we refer to it as a shorthand.
Shorthand, exactly. So, what we shall start with is what we call it the alphabet. Okay? The alphabet, many people, they understand that the Egyptian language is just like any other language. We have the alphabet, and from the alphabet we can have the words. And each word is a combination of a group of alphabet. That is right and wrong in the symbol. Why? Because the Egyptian letters are not giving just one sound, like A, B, C, or like in Arabic, Alif, B, T. No, it gives, we have group of letters gives one sound, like this group we are looking at. This is the vulture, or the eagle.
Eagle
gives one, the sound of A, or A like Alpha, like Ahmed, like Adam. We have the second group gives two sounds. We have the third group gives three sounds, and the fourth group gives four sounds. So this is the language, contains all the styles of languages, ancient or modern. Also, the shape of writing and how we read, as I told you, if the letter, and as you can see, most of it had faces, as you can see. So we can know the direction of writing, facing right or facing left. So it faces right, left, we read from left. It faces right, we read from right. Other style, from up to down. We use only right or left and down. Okay, like this case, if we imagine that this is all one line of writing, so it looks left. So we start from left and read down, and then we keep reading from the other side.
And, And I hope you don't mind me interrupting to add, if you do say so. This shows that it's the mother of all scripts, because Hebrew and Arabic are read from right to left, English left to right, and Asian languages top to bottom.
Yes.
So this shows it all starts.
Western languages from left to right, Middle East from right to left, and Asians from
top to bottom.
Why we don't have from the bottom to top? Because that is not existed. And if it is not existed in hieroglyphics, it will not exist in modern language.
Correct.
This is another proof about that the language is the origin of the source of the languages of the world.
Mother tongue.
Yeah. Okay, so let's start with the alphabet, the first sound letters. So we have the eagle, which is A. This is how we write A, if I will write what we call it, the transliteration. They make it in Latin style, so that is A. This is the shape of the leg and the feet, we call it B. This is, they call it like a piece of, maybe like a tissue, or like, this is according to Egyptology examination, because if I give you the alternative story, you may not find this on the internet, because most of the glyphs, 99% of what you are going to find is the official story. So I shall give you what you will find. Okay? This is representing, so that is letter S. Okay? The same letter S, but in a different shape. So that's why some people say, no, that is S, and that is could be Z. Mm. But also I do have another opinion. In Middle Eastern countries, especially Arabic, and I believe ancient Egyptian, we do have four letters different from what you have in Western languages. We have S and F. So one behind the teeth, S, the normal S we know. And when we must put the tongue a little bit between the teeth,
F.
Okay? Mm-hmm. And we have Z, the normal Z, and we have the same V. We both also the tongue. So in my opinion, the two S here playing like this. So one is S like we understand, and one is it like we do in Arabic language. That is D, that is the hand with the upper finger. That is what we call it E or I. That's why those names or those words are not the meaning. That is, you can see that the letter serving in this word, sign, easy, item. Like when I say also Muhammad, I will use one of these. If I say Waleed, I'm going to use one of this. So it is the sound itself. What we are saying that this is the letter, and the letter in English, that is not quite correct, because we must talk about the sound. Let me give you an example. If I say school, like chemistry school, it is S. If I write in hieroglyphic way, S K, not S C H. Oh, it will be S. The sound is what is K, so I will write it K. I will not write C H. I will use the one similar to the sound K. Okay. The same like phone. I will use the sound for F, not PH. So this one and the one below, they are playing the same. The sound similar to E or E or E. Okay. That is the sound, the viper. That is, by the way, they call it the fezzer. It could be a knife. This is the Egyptian Turesha snake. That is the name of the snake, Turesha. Short snake, like an arm size, fat, has two horns, and can jump 7 meters. Very, very strong poison. So they use it for the letter F. And we do have another snake, they use it for letter Z. And both snakes doing the same sound. Though this snake make it, that is the sound of the snake. Also, I forgot to tell you the eagle. The sound of the eagle is ah, ah, that is, so they use it for ah, okay? We're going to see some other letters, it gives the same sound as the ancient Egyptian said. This is sound, this is letter G. Somebody said it is like the base of a big jar of water. We're going to see this in the Nubian house. And we don't understand what this in the middle, maybe another base to support. So it looks like a base of something. And this is letter G. This one, someone asked me about this today. Okay. This is, we call it the front facade of the front part of the house. That's why if it is a word, we'll call it bir.
It was actually reversed.
Yes, because don't forget that it could be written this way or that way. But
depending on how the text is
written. Yeah, but for Western people, we bring the left side slide. Okay, so that is H. That is the second cell of the snake. We call it dish. Okay, dish or ish is not two sounds. For you, it is two sounds, D and J. But for us, it's one sound. What is that sound? We call it the G in a thirsty way. So it's like, say, gamal. Okay, we have gamal and jamal. We have, like, when you say, we can say agenda or agenda. So that is the same letter, G. So that is the style of the letter.
Or G or something.
Yeah. Okay. That is K. It looks like a mug style. That is the owl. M. Like Mohammed. That is the water wave. M. The chick. But this is not the baby chicken. This is the quail. Because again, Egypt didn't recognize or know chicken before New Kingdom time. Chicken came from Syria. This is what they say it was first used by Greco-Roman, but I show you some evidences that it was used from the Old Kingdom time existence, the lion. And in my opinion, according to the Mazar Tongue and according also the Ptolemaic, that it was used as L, never used as R, because we do have R. So why we have two letters pronounced R? But maybe, as we say, it was reused sometimes as R and sometimes as M. But I believe the original use was M. This is like a pillar in a square shape. This is P. This is the Western P. Because in Middle Eastern languages, we don't have P. We have the normal B. That's why we'll listen to many, many words with P, but we pronounce it B, because our tongue is not used to say that style of P. This is Q, like queen. Okay, we call it in Arabic Qaf or Qaf. That is looks like the shape or the side shape of a small mound. This is R, the mouse shape. That's why we say anyone had R in his name talks too much. This is the lake shape, like the one we saw in Karnak Temple. That is Sheen or Ish. Okay. So we don't have letter Ish in Western languages, right? Especially English. So we put S and H. This is what I'm talking about. When I write like Sean, so I don't need to write S and then bring H. No, we already have a letter serving this sound, H. This is T. Some people, they say it's half circle, and others say, no, that's the shape of the bread.
Loaf of bread.
Yeah.
Loaf of bread.
Yeah. That is T, and again can serve as T and this, or can be like the TH in English, that. Okay, one of the letters you must use your tongue outside the piece. This is rain. Doesn't exist in Western languages. Rain, but in is the Germans have this letter? Rain?
I don't think so.
I think Asians only have it. Mm-hmm. So rain in English they say GH. That's why most of the rain became G in English words. Like when we say Rada, that is an Egyptian name, Rada became Gada. Like we say Gandhi, we call him Gandhi in our language. Okay. This is also Ha. It became H. That does not exist in Western languages. Ha. similar to ha, but we a little bit stress here in the that part of the problem. Ha. And another one doesn't exist, but may Spanish has it and the German has it, yes. Which is ha. Okay, we call it ha from the top of the mouth, the ceiling of the mouth. This is another word called ayn. So when we don't say Omar Sharif, it's Omar Sharif. Okay, Omar by the Western languages. But our language, that is also one of the big mistakes they use it, because ayn, it serves in Western language according to how we put the vowel. Because we have adil, they say adil, so that is A. We say Omar, which is Omar, so they make it O. It's still the same letter, but the vowel after the letter, who changes the letter. And we say Aymad, they became Imad. That's why many people, when they write your names in cartouches, they use that letter. And I keep telling them that is wrong. That is not actual A. That is not right. They must use the vulture.
The vulture or the eagle?
The eagle, sorry. Okay. I think that was very easy, right? So we met the alphabet.
You have fancy cake.
Yeah.
How many letters are there?
The letters. Let's first meet the other. Look.
360.
Those are all the signs. So we have from A. Let's first teach you this. This is the easiest way now to understand or to how to find or how to read the word. Okay? You will look to the wall and you're going to see many signs. You will not recognize between the signs. You will not understand what does it say. Okay? So you need to study a lot, years, and you keep memorized words, vocabulary, so you can read the Hieroglyphs. Now I'm offering you a very easy slide. We shall recognize the letter or the sign. And look for this. What is this? This is what we call it, a code. Each symbol has a unique code, never repeated to the other symbol. So that shape is always A1. The second, A2. The third, A3. Like this. And then when we change to another group, we start with B. B1. B2, and keep moving like this. Okay? Then we have D. Then we have E, F, G, till the end of the letters or the symbols. So you can see all of them. I think now you recognize some of the things you saw. So let's say I want to know the meaning of this. Okay? So what we do, read the code R13, okay? So the first thing will help us is Gardner sign list, because you're going to use this. This is one of the things, one of the PDF files. I will be happy to give it to you and upload it in chemetology.com. You're going to find the tool now to help you. So again, we need to know the meaning of this, R13.
There's only one of the lists,
yes. Gardner sign list. So the sign list here shows each symbol with the number or the code and a briefing. It's not the exact meaning, but what we are looking for, that short meaning in the beginning. But this is too much to keep looking and searching. So in the end, we have a group of it. So we are looking for which one? R13. So let's go. That is first if you don't recognize the one above. So that is R. Okay, sorry, I made it wrong a little bit. Of course, when you see this, you will not see the code, okay? Because You saw it now, because I make it. But when you see this in the temple, you will not see the code, right? So you will look for the code now. We don't. Let's pretend we don't know the code. But let's change this one. Let's look for this one. This one.
Yes.
Okay. So we don't know the code, okay? So let's go to the sign list. Okay, from A. Okay, let's go. No, it's not this one, no. And sometimes you need to look to the picture again to make sure. Okay? All these are animals, netters. Parts of human animals again, okay, birds, fish and snakes.
Maybe like this, sky, okay? Earth, and water? So, mm-hmm. Let's look at sky, earth, and water. Nope, not there.
We will come to it. So you keep looking.
Temple's furniture.
Mm-hmm. Until you see it. Ah, here it is.
Ah! Crowns,
okay,
dress, stays.
So it is S18. S what? S18. Then we go to S18. This is U. R. Okay. Here it is. Okay. They say this is bead or necklace. That is the word,
Minit.
So that is the sign, but this is the complete word, Minit.
Minit.
Okay, and they call it necklace. So you can be happy with this, but maybe some will not be happy with this, right? Okay, so let's do what? Look in a bigger picture. That is not the dictionary, that is the sign list. So it gives the very basic meaning. But the dictionary, which includes many words, and this served not in one word, it served in many words, so we can understand the meaning in bigger scale.
And your footnotes give the two references. One is from Gardner, one is from P-U-Y.
Yeah,
P-U-Y.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay, so we do have another dictionary. We call it Vigus Dictionary 2012.
Wow.
So now we know what is the code, S-E-T. So let's go to S18.
That's great.
You're going to see here the beginning of the code, M. So we are in level M now. Okay, so let's go O. Okay. We are in S now, so let's. Here it is.
It's definitely sacred to Hathor, that's for sure.
Mm-hmm. So, it's still saying necklace, but it gives a little bit extra meaning. It says sacred to Hathor. Okay? Some words will give you more meanings in the dictionary, and some did because we choose actually hard one. But this is the way to how to read hieroglyphic. That you don't need to memorize all the letters, you don't need to memorize all the words. So we have now the easy way is the alphabet. You can understand the alphabet. And then you look for the code. And after you look for the code, you can depend on that dictionary and you can find the word you don't know. Okay? You know this word before having this kind of technology, let's say 10 years ago, okay? We used to spend maybe weeks to find one word because computers make it very easy.
To cross-reference.
But now PDF and I can find, and also not only this, but sometimes you can go, if you see the two signs, you can go easier because one sign, let's say it will be like this, S17, and the second sign is N35. Look to this, the one before, It is the same sequence. So they start with A, all A, and then AB, and then ABC, ABCD. So the code itself is arranged. So we are looking according to the code, not according to the letter. Other dictionaries according to the sign, but it takes also a long time. I keep looking in that sign, all the vulture, the eagle signs, all the owl signs. So I'm trying hard in those coming months to make it electronic. So instead of keep looking and scrolling, you will write the code, it will give you the word immediately, okay? Because what is impossible in this dictionary, if you have the word in English and you know, you want to see it in hieroglyphic, that is impossible, unless you know it. But if you are looking for word, let's say any word love, you need to read all of it to find the word love.
But the cross, what the programs do is make you able to cross-reference so quickly, which would take hours, like you say, right by hand. It's, that's a great advantage of the computer. You could go to different files immediately and cross-reference. And that's what you did with Gosford, which was brilliant. Brilliant.
Okay, I want also you to understand something very important, that when you look for a name or for a meaning, and you find someone else saying, no, 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 it's not like this, don't actually resist, because it, hieroglyphic, it is, the word may be clear for you, but it will be clear for the other person as a different meaning, because that the language wasn't spoken for a long time, okay? And also don't forget that who first started to read our language are the French in the beginning by Champollion, and then the British, the best book we ever had was Alan Gardiner, the Egyptian grammar of ancient Egyptian language, and then Wallace Budge. But because I am Egyptian, okay, me and Yusuf, and so we claim that we can read it better now. But of course we will not deny the effort in the language, because we opened the gate for us reading this.
Because they're all based on a Greek source, the Rosetta Stone, which may be mistranslation.
Exactly.
So the guidance for this is that based on the Rosetta Stone translation.
That's right. From Champollion. And we argue that the Greeks did not understand the signs. So
but
that
we still use, Champollion was depending also in Coptic language, because we say that the Coptic language is the third, the fourth way or the fourth part of the Egyptian language, but mixed it a little bit with some Greek letters. But honestly, still have so many of the vocabulary of ancient Egyptian language. And as Egyptian, again, we still speak many of our local words, mistakenly believe it's Arabic words, but it's not, and we found that it is Egyptian language. So again, this is the style of writing, okay? You can see it from right to left, from left to right, and here is vertical, here is horizontal. And this is again the alphabet. We have one sound, two sounds, three sounds. One sound is what we just saw, the alphabet, like F, R, A. And then we have two sounds, like the word men, okay? The word ber, the sign, it's one sign, but it says ber, two sounds. This sign, like a rectangular shape. One sign, but two sounds, ber. That is also one sign, two sounds.
Same with T.
Okay. So that is bird. That is men. Then we move to the third level. Three sounds. Hated. Ha T E. Nefer. Okay.
Tawi.
This is what I used to study in university. So we have the word, we have this word, he means another. Okay? But in ancient Egyptian language, the word he used to come after the word. So I don't say another man. Man, another. Okay? Kid for a feminine. It's another for a feminine word. And it means there. Bu means place. And this is one of the rare cases that it doesn't have plural, because it's already have bu in the end. So it could be bu, one place, or bu, many places. We have khit. It means that thing. Okay? And that thing, khit, most of the cases, it's a dry branch of a tree. You will hear Stephen saying aywa in many cases. Right?
Yes.
Say it.
Aywa.
This one, eu. But I believe aywa, that is the right word. It's not eu like said by the translator. It's aywa. It means aywa, it is like something you start with or shows acceptance. So when people start to speak, they say aywa, so it means I believe is what I'm saying. It is right. Okay? So this is Yusuf keeps saying we have the shin and the ren.
The
shin, we know the shin, which we call it cartouche nowadays. The ren is the name. The word name is ren. And we still say in Egypt when someone is very famous and wealthy, we call he has shanna and ranna. Many people, they don't understand exactly what this means, but now we understand. His name is written in a shin, so he is a royal style. And that word is mean jet, means say, to speak, and that is the word hina. This is one of the reasons that we could date writings. If we see this one, this surfaced during dynasties time. And the one I'm going to show you later surfaced during the late Egyptian time. So if I see this, I would say dynasties time. If I see the other inside or written with a text, I will start dating the other one to the Ptolemaic time. That is how also the owl shape, that shape, it means old kingdom, beginning of middle kingdom. Another shape also I'm going to show you, it is beginning or end of middle kingdom and beginning of new kingdom. So the language developed. But not as spoken language, as written language. I believe as a spoken language, it lasted all the time the same. But as written language, developed a little bit. Okay. Okay, let's think a little bit. If the Egyptian had the word debit, okay, means boat, like this. Okay.
Oh no, he's behind the screen.
So we have debit, boat, and then head sailing or ferry. That is from the early beginning. So it means that the Egyptians were sailing. But someone would say no, they were sailing on the Nile. But Hatshepsut gives us the evidence that Hatshepsut sent a fleet, as we saw the day before, yesterday, that she was sailing in the Red Sea. And who can sail in the sea can sail in the ocean, can sail everywhere, just a different size of a boat. But the conception is the same, wind and water, and the ship, bigger sail, and more men. So you will be able to go with it. This is the word sish in Cote d'Ivoire. They call it scribe, but now we call it the knowledgeable man. The man who knows many, many things. And that's the most example for this man was Imhotep. And Imhotep became a label, and many people were called Imhotep, many knowledgeable people. And with the beginning of the Ptolemaic times, they worshipped Imhotep as a god of knowledge. This is the word sejim. It's a verb to hear or to listen. Now this is our first lesson. So also look to this. So we saw just a word called debit. Boat, right? What is this?
Ayahuasca.
It's another boat. Okay. So it means that the Egyptians didn't use just one style of boat. They had many, and I'm going to show you more words for boat. We have a word called chib. Why the translator is called chib? Because it looks bigger.
By the way, that's incorrect spelling of bark.
Really?
It's B-A-R-Q-U-E.
That is old English.
Bark is something else that's from the tree.
That's old English.
That's right. They don't spell it B-A-R-K.
What did they intend there?
Well, that's where Spanish barco comes from.
Right.
In ship.
Right.
So it means ship.
B-A-R-Q-U-E is the English word.
Yeah, it's French. Bark.
Okay. This is one of the signs about the...
Embark on a journey.
No, bark of a tree. B-A-R-Q-U-E means the boat.
When we say Egypt was a civilized country, this is the proof. Why? This is the symbol.
And if you folks have noticed, you see that sign all over Egypt today. When
yes.
we're going?
Yeah. Newt.
All over Egypt, the sign today.
Okay. What is Newt? It is a square with crossing streets.
Yeah.
Okay. Also, that symbol... roads. So it means that the Egyptians were aware of roads. It was not just bath or place like, but it was a normal road back nowadays. And I believe they had stops, maybe checkpoints. So it was, but they give this symbol to the foreign land. Okay? And I believe the people who translated the language were more conservative. They didn't want to insult the others, because the Egyptian meant primitive people. They didn't make it and primitive or not civilized like the Egyptians.
Less developed.
Okay, because they gave that sign to everybody except Egypt.
Right.
And who made the same thing? I was surprised to find a Persian piece when they invaded Egypt, and they wrote the countries they invaded, and Kemet was on the list. So Kemet had this symbol to the Persians who made this, and he gave that symbol to everybody else, as if they admit about this fact.
That's good.
So this is the shin after became a long shape. It used to be a circle that way. So that is the where they can put the name, because the normal shin will not receive a name of 4 or 5 signs, but this shape can. And according to the name, it could be longer than this. Okay, so is the language is a matter of signs only and symbols, and then you find the word? No. It's a matter of grammar too. Okay? And it makes sense. Remember yesterday when I told you that sometimes they put the object first, sometimes the subject first, and according to the position. So the language was complete language, not just writings and symbols, and then they tell you, this means that. No, it was very good language. And my evidence that they had songs, they had poetry, and stories. We do have Sinuhi story, the sailor story, you know, Sinbad stories, originally ancient Egyptian. Okay, this is one of the very famous sentences. And this sentence is unique. When I talk about Gosford, I will explain why. This sentence is what we can call it Middle Eastern sentence. It's not Western at all. Why? It starts with verb. Weapon. Weapon means rise. Okay? In English or French or Western languages, we must add with the subject. The sun rises.
Right.
But here, rises the sun.
Right.
Okay? Rises the sun in the sky. The sun rises in the sky. So imagine when the Westerners wanted to read this, they must put the sun first. okay? Reshape the synthesis. This is one of the things I found in Gospel Glyphs, that it is written in that style, verb, subject, object. So for me, it's an evidence, because Western hand will always write Western style. It doesn't matter which language, okay? So this is the verb rise, this is the sun, and that is M, in or inside sometimes, and that is met sky. Okay? Look to this. This is the translation. Which one is correct? No one. Why? Because I just told you, rises the sun, not the sun rises in the sky. The sun rose. So they didn't even understand when they were talking about the best. They said, from the sense of the text, we will understand. It is modern or future. No, that is not right. I can show you later that we have signs like, remember Yusuf when I said, Minu, if he made those signs. So with Minu, we have the water sign. That is in, it means best. He made.
So you have tense.
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. So when the sun rose, okay, so it's another style. So that's all wrong. So the only meaning of this, rises the sun in the sky.
I
would try hard.
Everybody asks me if I'm writing a third book. I say to no, the next book in chematology will be Muhammad and Yusuf. Inshallah.
Inshallah. Very soon.
Awesome.
Okay. So this is what we understand as Western people. Ra imbed. Ra here, it's a noun. We can call it subject. M, in, and sky. The sun is in the sky. Okay. So when Gardner or anybody else will read this, will read it correct, because it matches the Western stuff.
So there's a different sign for sun, and then there's a different sign for Ra.
Exactly.
Look, yeah, right. So yeah,
I will show you.
So when they say Ra, they're not actually talking about the physical sun, they're talking about some sort of aspect of it.
This is what they say.
It's the second stage.
But I believe all means the sun, but different style of the sun.
There's five stages of the sun.
Oh, okay.
There it is. It was on the left.
Okay, so we have debit. Oh, they call it small book. And we have wea, ship. See? It's a ship. So the Egyptians were aware, ships will not sail in the night. You know, when we dock with this boat and we are two or three, it makes chaos in the night. And the Nile, yes, it's large and huge, but not in all the cases. In some cases, especially traveling north, it gets narrow to the north. Okay. And the Egyptians were not used or hired 40 men on a ship. How big is that? Is a big ship. If you count the crew, you will not find that number of men, okay? Even with oars. Because we're going to have the felucca after tomorrow, you're going to see only two, maximum three people controlling the whole big felucca. But we keep counting on the writings and the carvings. They represent many, many people with the oars. So it makes sense. It is for the sea, not for the night. Me and Yusuf were talking about this word this morning. Nijis. We're still using this word. Still using this word till now. They call it boor man or commoner. Okay? Boor man. Boor man from the point of view of another poor man is okay. The poor man from a point of view of a very rich man, arrogant man, means like very low position, very, what is the word in English to say, like, wadiya?
Commoner?
But let's say,
commoner?
No, not, it's like a criminal, but not criminal. You know that thing? Like you don't like to shake his hand or anything like this.
There's a lot of English words.
Yeah. Okay.
So, nefarious.
So the word moves from only poor man to someone.
Trailer trash. Trailer trash.
Okay. Exactly. So they didn't keep the same meaning, but also they add more meaning in nowadays, and it means now we call it negus with D, not G, and it means that someone you don't even like to stay next with him or stand or to be closer with him.
A low life.
Yeah, low life.
Lots of sense.
So
we have a lot of expressions in English.
Have you heard before the word sissayit? They used to call it for men in the Middle Ages. Call it sissayit. It means like my master. Or the man who control everything. Ask the Egyptian, what does it mean to Sayyid originally? They will not tell you why. A Sayyid we know. A Sayyid means master. Or like lord, or like this kind of title. But C, they don't know what does mean C. This is C. It's man. The man of the house. And also, they call lady Set. The same like Set. Not set of Arabs, that word set, it's still called, ladies are nowadays in Egypt, they call it set, lady, the woman. Okay. Here is the question of killing.